Good morning, Flosstube. Welcome to my very first Flosstube Extra. This morning I'm going to show you how to put together the little floss sample cards that I showed in my Flosstube number 2 video. This won't take very long because it really couldn't be more simple, but a few of you asked for a little bit more information, a little bit more detail. So it's probably a bit grand to call this a tutorial, but here we go. First of all, I'll put a little picture up here by the magic finger of Flosstube to show you all that you need to create these little sample cards. So you'll need a pair of scissors, you will need some form of card. Now, I use this just because it is what I had. That was a free pack of cards that came with a quilting magazine to allow you to create a quilting swatch. So I have used this, and I've run out, so I'm now making my own just by cutting this a shape from a template. However, you can very easily get some very nice craft tags on Amazon for not a huge amount of money that you could do exactly the same with. And you have to admit that those are prettier, and if I'd had some forethought, that's what I would have done. But I didn't, so here I am with my plainer tags, but they work perfectly well. So I'm going to show you this morning. So you've got scissors, you've got a tag, you need a little bit of washi tape. Okay, I just use cheaper washi tape. I don't use like the really expensive fancy scrapbooking kind. So something from one of the bargain stores is just fine for this purpose. As long as it sticks well, it does the job. You could use regular sellotape as well, but I think washi tape works just nicely. And then you have your leftover piece of floss. So sometimes this will be, as I showed you in my second video, sometimes this will be a selection of the flosses that are left over in kits that have DMC numbers. And other times I will do this from a clean new skein of floss that I've ordered in a number that I've never had before. And I'll take the first 18 inches or so off to wrap around the card so that I've got a reference for that in the future. And so here we go. I'm going to show you how I do it. It's really very simple. So I've got my card. As you can see from my little ring of cards, I have decided to put two colors on each card, so they'll be consecutive numbers. I do this by number, because I think that's the easiest way for me to identify something from a pattern. So when a pattern calls for 738, I can find 738. I don't have to know that 738 is a brown or whatever color it happens to be. So I can go to that. If then I'm using these to choose colors, then if I know that I need, let's say 727 and it's a yellow, let's see, there we go, 727 is a yellow, but maybe in my stash I have one of these, 745. It's not a million miles away, and I can see, would it work for me? So that's how I do it. These cards are all on a ring, so I can always take them off by color. Sorry, I'm very fidgety because I'm nervous. I can take them off by color and choose between the different color variations quite easily. But just for me, I find that having them stored by number is easier. Do whatever you find easiest and works best for you. Okay, so I've got my remaining threads, or my brand new piece of thread from a floss pack. I've got my card. I'm going to tape it with a tiny piece of washi tape. I'm just going to tape it onto the back of the card, like so, and then trying to keep a nice straight line, I'm just going to wrap the floss around the card. This is really hard to do on video. So here we go. I'm just wrapping it round just so that I can create a nice, neat color swatch on the front. There we go. Now, sometimes when I'm taking this off a full brand new skein of floss, obviously I've got the full 6 strands here in my piece, but sometimes if it's leftovers from a project, I might just have four strands or two strands. I just use that. I just use whatever I've got. It doesn't have to be a particularly thick strand of floss. It doesn't have to have all six strands on it to make it a good sample. So I just use what I've got left. Now I've got it wrapped around, so I'm just going to trim that end a little bit so that I can stick it on the back again with another piece of washi tape. So just trim a tiny bit off there. Okay, I'm holding that fast and I'm going to pop on another piece of washi tape just to secure that end. So you can see here's the first piece of washi tape underneath and the second piece on the top. Easy peasy. And there's your colour swatch. Sorry, I keep putting it in front of my face, but it was getting washed out this morning. There we go. Okay, so now all that's left to do is to label it, because it's not much use to you if you haven't labelled it with the number. So I just get my trusty pen. I write on the top that it's DMC. Now I have only done this for my DMC threads, but you might want to do it for all of your fancy flosses and other things too. So always make sure that you put your thread brand on the top. And this one is 959, I forgot to look. This one is 959 DMC. And then I will file it in color order on my ring. And I have three of these rings, so you might also find a better way of storing them that suits you better, whatever it is. But it doesn't have to be complicated. It just has to work. So I hope that has helped. I hope that you see that there's no magic in it and that you've enjoyed it. And I'm just going to add on to the very end here a little video of my floss storage. It's not hugely exciting because it's only a very small stash. Most of my skeins are in project bags awaiting my attention, but I'll just show you what I've got and how I've organized it, just in case you're interested. Doesn't take too long. If you're not interested, skip ahead. I hope to be back later this week with floss tube number 3, and I'll see you all then. Stitch happy and stay well, folks. Bye. This top tray has all of my fancy flosses. That is my entire stash there on the left, with the exception of the few skeins of Loganberry that I have in the Home Sweet Home kit. I don't have lots of fancy floss. I'm really mainly a DMC girl, and a lot of that's down to cost and inexperience. So perhaps it'll grow, perhaps it won't. We'll watch this space. Recently, I also picked up a few packets of the Silky Petites in 12 weight, and there's an Aurifil 12 weight spool in there as well, and that I have from my quilting stash, and I hope to try those soon. I've heard really good reports about them, so I thought I might give the Silky a go, and I picked up just a couple of little color sets, and we'll see where they go. Also, you can tell from the colorways in this that I'm hoping there might be some red samplers in my future somewhere. And I also have this little quilt now acrylic ruler. This is a quilting ruler. It's a 2.5 inch width ruler that came free with a magazine a few years back, but it's perfect for me to do the measuring of my corners when I'm starting a piece of work. So I use it as a corner gauge, and it works really well. Below the silkies, I have stickers and thread cards, and sometimes there are floss rings in there, but I think everything is out in bags at the moment. That is my floss card. That is my DMC color samplers all on the rings. I've showed you how I make those and what I do with those. And above that, this is my DMC stash. As I said, I have loads of DMC in actual project bags, but here I've got bobbinated ones that aren't in use, and the full skeins are duplicates of things that are already on bobbins. And I do manage my thread stash by a spreadsheet now, so that I know where that DMC number of thread is, whether it's in this box or whether it's in a project, and I have the project allocation to it. And it's really helpful also
because I can allocate a thread to several projects and know that it will be in one of those bags because it can be shared. There's enough to be shared around the several projects. It's a really good way of helping me not to overspend and overbuy threads. Yeah, and that's a good thing. And just on the lid of that side of the box, you can see the little cards that I normally keep in. I have my DMC bobbin cards. I know they're controversial, not everybody likes them, but I find them a handy way of storage. So I have DMC bobbin cards, I've only one left, so I need to order some more. And I have the little tag cards that I use for my sampling. And that's a little roll of washi tape, which I just use to stick the samples on at the back of the sample. So I'll have shown you that already. So I thought you might like to see that this is where I keep my stash. And just in the bottom drawer here, I have some of the tags that go on my project bags and a little bitty board, which I use sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes. And that's my thread stash.